are going to be talking about passports. I'm going to take you on a little adventure. We're going to be renewing a passport here in Mexico for the very first time. Before we moved down, we renewed a few passports, including, I think, Justin and, of course, Amelia. That was our biggest obstacle before we could get down to Mexico, was giving birth to baby and then getting her birth certificate expedited, her social security card expedited, and then her passport expedited so we could get down here in time. So anyway, we have some of us with pretty much brand new passports, but then Constance, she got her passport when she was a little baby, and since those passports are only good for 5 years, it is time to renew hers. So come along with us and let's renew a passport. Step number one, make an appointment online. Step number two, collect all the documents that you need. So, the things we need passports. We need Constance's old passport and also a photocopy of it. Everything, they said, everything should be the original and a photocopy. So Constance's. We also need mine and Justin's passports with copies to prove we're her parents and to also prove, this is also going to prove her citizenship, along with her birth certificate is also necessary, and a social security card. So, social security card, I actually don't know if I need a copy of that. I think I might just need the number for the actual form we're going to fill out for her, which is DS-11, just to let you all know. We haven't printed that off yet, so we need to print that and fill it out. But that form, we need to have her social security number on that form, and that's all that it said on the website. But I'm going to be extra cautious, and we're going to bring her actual original social security card with her, with a copy. Okay, so some interest, and so let's see. So we need the application. We need all these forms of proof. They said we might need secondary proof of things, so we're also going to be sure to bring like her school ID that has her picture on it with a copy, as well as they said like if you need proof of, I think this is related to birth, that a secondary form of proof could be, let's see, can I find it in here? Hospital bracelets or like a hospital birth certificate, which I'm hoping this will work. So we're gonna bring this along, her baby book. Now, I haven't been the best at keeping baby books for all our kids, but I was pretty good with Stancy. And another way that this might come in handy, listen to this, it's fascinating. Because of the fact that Constance's picture on her old passport is as a baby, it said if that child doesn't look the same, you need to have transition photos. So I'm thinking that this baby book is gonna come in really handy because I've been pretty good at keeping up with it. I can't say the same about poor Amelia, but we have pictures of her first birthday, her second birthday, her third birthday, and her fourth birthday, which unfortunately is not a face. So we might need to get a little more current, but I feel like that transition photos, it had no more explanation other than you may need transition photos. So we're also going to need to take her pictures today, and so yeah, I think that'll be, and then of course we need money, but I think that's all the documentation. So, and I would say the only hiccup that we ran into was trying to make photocopies of all of our documents, meaning our United States passports, Constance's expired United States passport, IDs, that kind of thing. We went to our nearest Office Max thinking that might be a good location, and they, the day before we got there, they had enforced a new rule, which I think they say is supposed to last forever, that they won't make copies of official documents there. So it wasn't very difficult to find a smaller print shop, and they actually made the photocopies, the colored copies, for much cheaper. Number three, you need to have the correct size passport, United States passport photos. Now, this was difficult for us. We decided to get her pictures taken at a nearby pharmacy. They took the picture for us and printed it, but Mexican passport size is about 2 inches one way, which is the same as a United States passport photo, but the other dimension is closer to about an inch, and a US passport photo needs to be a square of 2x2. So we had to be creative. We took some photos of her further back so we could print a full 4x6 photo and just cut out a square of her head. The issue with that was my fault. I took it against a wall that was white, but appeared to be more gray once we printed it. So, long story short, when we got to the embassy, we found out directly across the street, there is a store or a little shop that will take United States passport size photos for you. Super quick, super easy, maybe like a 5 minute wait total. We got three photos printed for 80 pesos, which is approximately $4.50. So our recommendation is get there early and just go across the street and get those photos. Step number four is arrive 15 minutes before your scheduled appointment time. Now, this proved to be much more difficult for us than we had expected or anticipated. The latest appointment time that we could find, because we were trying to hurry and get in there as soon as possible, was 9:15 in the morning, which meant we needed to leave Puebla around 6 o'clock to give us plenty of cushion time. We woke up later than we should have, and by the time we got out the door and looked at the estimated, on our GPS, the estimated duration of our trip, it was saying 2.5 hours, and we literally had maybe 2 hours and 45 minutes. One of the things you should always know about traveling to Mexico City is that traffic is very, very real and very unpredictable. So we really should have given ourselves a bigger cushion. We got to really, really close to the embassy and we had 15 minutes to spare. So we were gonna get there pretty much right on time. I was so excited, except that I misread our GPS and we took a wrong turn and we had to make a loop, which with traffic ended up taking an additional 15 minutes. So we arrived in front of the embassy at exactly 9:15. And there is no parking in the front of the embassy. You do need to drive around to the backside and pay for some public parking and then walk back. So anyway, what I'm saying is definitely give yourselves more cushion time to arrive. Step number five is lines. Lines, lines, lines. When you get there, they're gonna put you in a line on the side of the embassy underneath a big green tent area. I guess it's not very big. It's more like one of those large size beach umbrellas that's green. So you're gonna walk toward there and you're gonna get into one line, which is to check your documents and check your appointment time. And then after that, they send you to the other line under the green tent where you wait. Then you get sent to the line in front of the embassy where you would go through a gate. Then you go through all the security check. After that, you go into another line outside of the embassy. And again, they'll check more IDs and they'll give you, all the adults will get like a lanyard with a tag on it. Then you get into the next line, which is where you sit. This time it has seats. You sit in a line. Then eventually they call you in and you finally actually get through the doors of the embassy. And then you go upstairs and you go to the actual room that is for processing passports, where you get in another line, and when you get called to a window, you present all your documents. They're gonna collect all your documents, and then they'll send you to another line where you're going to pay for your passport, and then you'll sit down in a waiting room, and eventually they will call you up for your interview. They call it an interview,
And that is where you will vouch for all your documents and sign in front of the official. And then you, oh, actually, I forgot. Then the last line. Then you go to the line where you're going to pay for the shipping. They use DHL to ship all the passports here within Mexico. And there is like a little DHL office within the embassy, which happened to be closed. So if it is closed, then you'll have to, like us, you'll have to leave the embassy and you'll need to go down the street to where the actual DHL like store is. And you'll get in that line where you will pay for your shipping. And you're done with lines. One other side note, I forgot, when you're going through security, they're going to take all of your electronics. So I read ahead of time that it said don't bring laptops and like big electronic devices, and actually try to limit everything you're bringing. Just pretty much bring the documents you need. And we obviously had our cell phones with us. So when you go through security, you'll turn it off and they're gonna collect it into, they'll put it in a bag and store it for you, and then as you're exiting, you get to get back your cell phones and all your electronics. In general, everything went fairly smoothly. Everyone working there was extremely helpful and kind. Doing anything with three children can often become a little stressful and hectic, but it truly was quite an adventure. And I wish I had known a little bit more ahead of time. So hopefully this will be good tips for you for if you need to renew a passport for sure here within Mexico at the United States Embassy in Mexico City. But also if you're just overseas abroad and renewing passports. So Poppy, are we happy or are we sad right now?
I'm always happy.
And now I'm happy because we have found a place that is willing to make our colored coffees for us. And
for 1/5 the price.
For exactly a fraction. There we go. The fraction is 1/5.
It's 20%.
For 1/5 of the price of Office Max. So, if anyone's living in Puebla, wants a recommendation of a good print shop.
Yeah, what's the name of this print shop?
I have no idea. But I'll tell you where to come.
It's this.
It's this.
Nope.
I don't know what it's called, but it's a great spot. So, anyway.